One of the key concerns was the overall theme of fitness of kids. One is in terms of physical fitness, second in terms of social fitness. And the belief that sports presents a very powerful medium by which kids can get physically fit and active and socially fit towards teamwork, leadership and all those other life skills as we call it. And that was a missing component in children's upbringing today. So our whole idea was, how do we make that a part of every child's education and upbringing?
My village has only one primary school, so I went to Delhi, my aunt's house, to complete further studies. In the final year of the graduation, I came back to my village and I found that very few people knew about the computer education.
Seeing my own little kids in school, I felt that they can be happier, they can have a more joyful learning experience. Can we redefine education? Can education be more exciting? Can learning be more simpler? Because human beings are learners, and how do we look at schooling in a more holistic manner?
We have been told that education will lead to a good and decent life. Many youth commit years of life to that. But we also know that 85 to 90% of students, especially in rural India, struggle with education quality and have trouble getting employment matching their potential.
Has had the opportunity to travel to various slums, shanties of Mumbai. And whenever I used to travel there, when I used to go and meet the women, the younger generation had a twinkle in their eye, had desire to do something. But the family income, the family opportunity will not give them the space, will not give them the scope to grow.
The solution to that problem of getting kids to play across India, in our view, is school-centric. So the need to integrate into the school system, to engage all stakeholders, to run it with like education is the key answer. And we run sports and physical activity with the same structure, rigor, assessment, parent involvement, teacher training, as you would expect science or maths to be run. So by giving it the same importance in terms of the overall tools around it and assessment, we are hopefully able to deliver a much better quality of experience on the sports front, and therefore get kids fitter for life, right, with the right skills for life, and therefore they'll keep playing for life.
Rose Computer Academy provides computer literacy in rural Haryana and has no admission criteria, and seek to provide education to anyone that desires knowledge. Most of our students seek employment or become entrepreneurs, thereby providing livelihood opportunities to rural Haryana who normally lack equitable access to these opportunities. The full form of ROSE is Rural Organization for Social Empowerment, and we want to achieve it through computer literacy.
We have two broad verticals, I would say, in Easy Vidya. One being the product, and the vertical, the team that works in the product, things of ways and means to create endearing products to our customers. How can these products help our clients, the schools, the teachers and the students look at education in a different manner? How can they enjoy, how can they be motivated on a continuous basis to make learning meaningful and enjoyable? On the other side, we also believe that face-to-face interaction, services, being with these stakeholders is very critical, So our services division work very closely with all the stakeholders. We have training programs for teachers. We have a training program for educational leaders. We also do a lot of face-to-face interaction with parents, opening their eyes and opening their minds to what education can be.
We have created a social learning network, which is like Facebook, YouTube, Wikipedia, Twitter, all combined, but rural enabled and with a focus on education, employability and employment. When the students interact, we track and collect the data and use it to enhance the experience and effectiveness in a personalized way. We are transforming human resource to productive talent and do that at almost zero cost.
We had a huge legal awareness conclave at Mathura Das Vasanji Hall, that's at August Kranti Maidan. And Renuka Chaudhary, she was a woman and child minister, she had come there. And when she saw this massive enclave and number of women, she also suggested to Susi, man, why don't you start a woman taxi service? That hit the bullseye. For 3 months, we teach them 2 hours on the road, how to drive, but there is self-defense, there is yoga, because you know, 12 hours you are on the road, I mean, you have to be mentally confident, you have to be prepared. So we give them yoga, we give them self-defense. There is also a knowledge about Mumbai, where you get the best saris, which are the hotels, of course not Taj, always the Taj in the Oberoi's, but which are the lower hotels. We have tied up with Mumbai Tourism. You know, this is this Interdivil India. And they also take our driver for a round in the city of Mumbai, knowing them about the roads. But good food, good restaurant, where do you get in Mumbai, that we focus on. Each Priyadarshini taxi driver has a card in their name, which gives their personal number. So they give that card. While giving the Priyadarshini card, our call center number is there and her number is also there, which develops the self-dignity. We also have a package for 2, 4, 6, 8 hours. There are many, many people who come to Mumbai, come in the morning and go back in the night. So we have 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours package. We also have package for pregnant women.
We are proud to be Sankalp Award finalists because as a team, I think it is a great validation of the social impact that we think we've been creating. It is really humbling to be selected in the final list amongst a whole host of other companies that are doing some brilliant work. And lastly, I think the exposure and the access to resources, people, networks, learnings that will hopefully help us scale the business faster as we go ahead.
Sankalp Form has been a huge learning ground to understand what it takes to approach a funding opportunity. Additionally, it helped me network with other social entrepreneurs and understand various models in the education field.
We are indeed proud to be Sankalp Award finalists, because it not only reinforces the faith and hope that we have in ourselves, but also is a huge driving and motivational force for entire team EasyVidya. And we are proceeding in our journey, we are going about in our journey in a more strong manner because of Sankalp Award, being the finalist at the Sankalp Awards.
Sankalp Forum is an ecosystem bringing in multiple stakeholders to accelerate and appreciate the newer model for impact, namely social enterprise. Orienting and mentoring pioneers and visionaries into this new way of thinking is what is most attractive about Sankalp Forum.
I'm proud to be the Sankalp finalist. Thank you for the opportunity.